Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the College Day for the academic year 2020-21. Today is a day to look back and reflect upon the year that passed by and offer the warmth of grace and gratitude for all the wonderful feats that our institution and its community of students and faculty have achieved. This last year has been one that was fraught with challenges that put an end to the kind of life that we knew. And yet, here we are today, fighting against the current, finding ways to move on and emerging stronger and better than ever before. A most genial welcome to the 96th College Day celebrations of St. Teresa's College. Before we begin, let us join our souls in seeking the comfort, grace and strength of the Almighty.
You are my hiding place. You always fill my heart with songs of deliverance. Whenever I am afraid, I will trust in you. I will trust in you. Let the weak say, I am strong in the strength of my Lord.
On this occasion, I'd like to offer a warm welcome to our Provincial Superior and Manager, Reverend Dr. Sister Vinita, our Director, Reverend Sister Emlyn, Chief Guest, Reverend Father Ebogen Arakil, Chancellor of Archdiocese of Verapalli, our Principal, Dr. Lizzie Matthew, Senior Administrator of the College, Dr. Sajimol Augustine, Vice President of the PTA, Sri P. Chandrasekharan, and President of Aastha, Srimati Suma Ravindran. I would also like to bestow a hearty welcome to everyone who joined us online today in this moment of celebration. Welcome all. Reverend Dr. Sister Vinita CSST, with her dynamic personality, is an epitome of leadership. A former member of the Department of English for 26 years, she served as principal of the college during the year 2014-15. She was then appointed director of the institution and steered the college during the initial years of autonomy. In recognition of her accomplishments and service, she has now been appointed Provincial Superior and Manager of the Congregation of CSST Sisters. She has been a trailblazer in expanding the horizons of St. Teresa's College and has always encouraged the efforts of the staff and students. May I now invite Reverend Dr. Sister Vinita for the presidential address.
Good morning. Dear Reverend Father Ebogen Arakil, Chancellor, Archdiocese of Vadapura, Reverend Sister Emmeline, Director, Dr. Lizzie Matthew, Principal, Dr. Sajimol Augustine M., Senior Administrator, Sri P. Chandrasekharan, Vice President, PTA, Srimadi Suma Ravindran, President, Aastha, dear Deans, Academic Deans, Heads of the Departments, Student Union, and my dear students, parents, well-wishers. We are here today to celebrate the College Day of our college. We are facing a situation that is unprecedented in history, with lockdowns and with fear and uncertainties, we are moving forward. This College Day should have taken place in the month of February or even March. We did not have the opportunity to come together. And we waited for things to subside. And now, very late, we decided to go online in a virtual celebration of this College Day. I think the world is changing and adapting itself to accept the unchangeable and go virtual. We do not know when this situation will become normal. And even if it becomes normal, I think it will be a blended situation that we have to handle. A college day celebration is a must for a college, because that is the time the college evaluates its activities of the year. Our college is celebrating now the 96th college day. And for 96 years, we have passed many milestones. And again, our journey continues. When we celebrate today, this 96th college day, we take stock of all the achievements that has taken place, that we achieved in the year, in the last 95 years. As I said, we have grown, and we give glory to God for making our growth possible through difficulties and through success. I congratulate the deans for arranging this virtual platform to celebrate today. We will not be having an elaborate celebration. It's only in a miniature form, the prize distribution, which is one of the hallmarks of a college day, will be done in a virtual way. The students' names will be announced and the prizes will be collected from the departments by the students. And definitely the presentation of the reports, because that is the record of our achievements and the record of our struggles. Taking this day, or marking this day as an important day, I congratulate all the winners of record-breaking victories. I appreciate the students who have done well. The students, despite the fact that they were not able to be present in the campus, did their best in academics and in other competitions. Also, and congratulate the teachers who motivated them. Also, I congratulate the parents who stood by the students, encouraging them to face the uncertainties. May God bless all our endeavors. And let us work together, holding hands, and march forward to another milestone in our history. May God bless all of us, give us the motivation, give us all the graces that we need, give us the energy to march forward despite the difficulties that we face in life. I congratulate the principal who was not able to function in a normal way during her tenure. A few months are left for her, and I hope situations will become better so that she will be able to see all her students in the campus and this auditorium bubbling with life and energy, and hold every activity offline in the near future. And once again, this campus will bustle with life. May God Almighty shower His enormous graces in this campus and on every student, teachers, and all the well-wishers. I wish the entire team of teachers and students, the principal and the director, and all the well-wishers, everything that is best for the coming year. Thank you very much. God bless you.
Thank you, sister. Our principal, Dr. Lizzie Matthew, with her illustrious leadership, has enabled the smooth functioning of the college even during these times of crisis. I now request her to present the annual report for the year 2020-21.
To accomplish great things, we must not only act but also dream, not only plan but also believe. Before I began this report, it seemed apt to quote Anatole France, French intellect, journalist, and a renowned man of letters. As I proceed, I thank our Lord Almighty for blessing us with numerous opportunities to dream, believe, and work upon our plans to accomplish greater things for our college, even during these unprecedented pandemic times. A warm good morning to all. This year marks the 96th academic year of our college, and as you all are well aware, this year has been like none before. I'm thankful, humbled, and proud of every member of the Theresian family who braved and steered through the turbulent waters of COVID-19 to help the smooth sail of the Theresian ship. I remember the precepts of our foundress, and in every step of our way, we reaffirm the vision of Mother Teresa of St. Rose of Lima, for hers was a vision to empower women to create a civilization of love. Thinking of the overwhelming times that we are in, I am filled with joy and thankfulness as I present a brief report of the accomplishments of the college during the academic year 2020-21. Over the years, with blessings from above and around, the college has received many prestigious awards. This year, I am happy to inform you that the college was ranked 47th in the National Institutional Ranking Framework in 2020 and was awarded a 4-star rating in the IIC Institutional Ranking. The college will forever cherish the special mention given to our extension activities by the Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi during the show Mann Ki Baat. It's my pleasure to announce that our Provincial Superior and Manager, Reverend Sister Dr. Vinita, received the Viscomp Sahas Sreshta Award for her valuable contributions to women's education, along with Dr. Lata Nair R., Associate Professor, Department of English, who was awarded with the Viscomp Sahas Prerana Award for leading collaborative gender equity initiatives. This year too, Reverend Sister Vinita continues her success story by receiving the Guru Puja Award instituted by the Kerala Catholic Bishops Council Media Commission for her exemplary services rendered in the field of education. I must acknowledge the numerous awards backed by the NSS unit of the college. Our NSS unit was selected as the best NSS unit of the university for the year 2019-20. Ms. Adira Babu of the Department of English was chosen the best NSS program officer for the academic year 2019-20, and Ms. Shweta K.R. and Ms. Dina Susan Jacob were chosen as the best student volunteers. The Society of Theresians for Environment Protection, STEP, of the college was also granted the UNDP Green Innovation Fund to aid innovative startups with the support of B Plan Studio, a business consultancy wing of the Department of Management Studies. The Teresa Memorial Award, instituted by the management to honor a woman achiever of the highest social standing, was awarded to Srimati K.K. Shailaja, Health Minister of Kerala, for her efforts in efficiently anchoring our health department with grit and strength during the pandemic. St. Francis College has now on its rolls 213 teaching staff and 71 non-teaching staff functioning in 25 departments with 3,668 students. I am assured that the dedication and commitment of the staff and students have undoubtedly made St. Teresa's a benchmark to measure academic, co-curricular, and extracurricular excellence today. The college offers 67 programs, including 2 BVoc programs, 25 postgraduate programs, 3 MPhil programs, 7 PhD programs, 3 PG diploma programs, 5 UG diploma programs, 25 add-on courses, and 10 certificate courses. I am proud to inform you that this year we got the opportunity and resources to start 12 new academic programs. These are an integrated MA in Social Sciences and a Master of Commerce in Management under the Kerala State Higher Education Council, 4 postgraduate and 1 undergraduate program under the NSQF, an MVOC in Food Processing Technology, and 4 diploma courses, further 2 value-added courses and 2 bridge courses. Wishing the best to all these programs and its initiators. I applaud the IQAC for rising up to the needs of the times and executing projects like Project Sumanas to provide laptops to deserving students. Under the Paramarsh scheme, the cell has also hosted workshops and programs for the enhancement of 7 mentee institutions assigned. I must also mention the Theresian Teaching Learning Center, an IQAC initiative that promotes innovative educational practices among the teaching and student community. Development of required infrastructure is imperative to a growing college. I am happy to inform you that this year we have constructed 3 more stories to the central block, which also includes the St. Joseph's Hall, an air-conditioned auditorium with a seating capacity of 200 people. Theresian Research and Consultancy Cell, TRAC, emerged out of the vision to inspire students to appreciate the relevance and contours of research. The institution has 7 research centers recognized by MG University, has 33 research guides and 127 research scholars, and is widely perceived as one of the finest centers for coursework under the university. TRAC organized many national webinars, faculty development programs, offered coursework for research scholars, and held sessions on recent trends in research. Sister Mary Cecil Memorial Award for Best Publication and Management Aided Research Grant, MARG, for Transdisciplinary Research are awarded to deserving faculty members under the directions of TRAC. The college has 24 functional MOUs and several collaborations with a number of international and national institutions and organizations. I appreciate the Theresian International, the international wing of the Research and Development Department, for making remarkable strides at the global level this year. The Research and Development Department has 3 functional MOUs with Study India under MHRD, UAE Exchange, and International Skill Development Corporation, ISDC. Apart from these, MOUs have also been signed with national organizations like ISEC, iNurture Education Solutions Private Limited, and Uni Academic Consultants. The previous year saw a number of textbooks and books authored and co-authored by members of our faculty. Let me begin with the in-house publication that the college has to its credit. They are Theresian Journal of English Studies, an international journal published by the Department of English and Center for Research. Journal of Environment and Society, published by the Department of Economics and Center for Research. And finally, the Theresian International Journal of Chemical Sciences, published by the Department of Chemistry and Center of Research. I am proud to announce that faculty members of various departments have also made individual contributions in their respective fields. I congratulate the following teachers for their authoring books: Dr. Bina D, Dr. Arya P. Mohan, Ms. Soumya John, Ms. Susan Thomas Chali, Dr. Priya K. Nair, Dr. Preeti Kumar, and Dr. N. Dhanya. And for the contribution of chapters to books, I commend Dr. Nisha Vikraman, Dr. Anu Joseph, Dr. N. Dhanya, Dr. Jensi Teresa, Dr. Shilpa Jose, Dr. Rashmi Pujara, Dr. Asha D, Dr. Sajida J. Kurup, Ms. Surya M. Kotaram, and Engineer Bhavya E. P. I would also like to appreciate all the members of our faculty who have published articles in peer-reviewed international, national, and e-journals of repute. Your efforts were assuredly a cheer in such pandemic times. The story of this institution will forever be carved by the vitality of our faculty who put in years of dedicated service. We extend our sincere gratitude and good wishes to our retiring staff, Dr. Romley Margaret Mendes, Controller of Examinations and Associate Professor of the Department of Botany, Dr. Tessie Antonisi, Dr. Beena Job and Srimathi Arthasheri Magdalene, Associate Professors of the Department of English, Dr. Geeta Andrews, Associate Professor, Department of Chemistry, Dr. Nirmala Padmanabhan, Department of Economics, Dr. Tara Sebastian, HOD and Assistant Professor, Department of Home Science, and Reverend Sister Ansrita, CSST, UGC Librarian. May God guide and bless you as you embark a new chapter. The year and its confines did not stop our faculty from raising laurels and marking milestones in their career path. I would like to take this opportunity to commend the individual achievements of the members of the faculty. Ms. Drishya PP of the Department of Bharatanatyam was awarded the National Level Kala Naipunya Puraskar by Kalanidhi Charitable Trust, Trivandrum. She was commended for her contributions in the field of Mohiniyattam. Dr. J.R.T. Varki of the Department of Chemistry was awarded the Berkman's Award 2020 as the best teacher from government and aided colleges in Kerala. The award is instituted by the Alumni Association of SB College, Chenganasheri. Dr. Jensi Teresa of the Department of Commerce received the Best Presentation Award in the AICT-sponsored national conference hosted by GEET University, Odisha. Dr. Nirmala Padmanabhan of the Department of Economics received a letter of appreciation from the Kerala Institute of Local Administration. She was appreciated for her research on shelter camps during the Kerala floods 2018. Dr. Nirmala Padmanabhan and Dr. Pearlie Antony of the Department of Economics were awarded with a letter of gratitude and a certificate of appreciation by the Kunnugara Panchayat for their efforts in documenting the COVID response activities of the Panchayat. Dr. Mary Leah CA of the Department of Economics received a letter of appreciation from Kunnugara Panchayat for her work in documenting the activities of the Panchayat for 5 years. Dr. Priya K. Nair, the Department of English, who is currently on deputation at Kerala State Higher Education Council, was listed as one of the 12 Indian women authors to watch out for 2021 by BoundIndia.com, a website that fosters creative literary communities. Engineer Bhavya E.P. of the Department of Food Processing Technology contributed a chapter entitled Food and Agriculture to a book on COVID-19 and its impacts. The book has been registered in the India Book of Records and Asia Book of Records for having maximum authors contributing. Srimathi Rosemary Francis of the Department of Home Science was awarded the Best Presentation Award in a national webinar conducted by the Home Science Association of India during their Kerala chapter. I congratulate Dr. Shanti A. of the Department of Physics for receiving the prestigious IASC INSA NASI Summer Research Fellowship for Teachers in 2021. Dr. Anju K. Nair of the Department of Physics received the Best Presentation Award in an international conference organized by the Government College of Arts, Science and Commerce in Goa. Dr. Thomas K. M. of the Department of Physical Education claimed the silver medal in the Men's Doubles Badminton Championship conducted by MG University Physical Education Teachers Association. He also claimed the bronze medal in the Kerala State Masters Handball Championship and has been selected to represent Kerala in the National Masters Handball Championship. Ms. Nisha Philip of the Department of Physical Education claimed the gold medal in the Mixed Doubles Badminton Championship and the silver medal in the Women's Doubles Badminton Championship conducted by MG University. I am happy to announce that the following members were awarded with doctoral degree this year. Dr. Jensi Teresa of the Department of Commerce, Dr. Vinita T. Taragan of the Department of History, Dr. Anuraj of the Department of Management Studies, Dr. Elizabeth Reshma M.T. of the Department of Mathematics, Dr. Mary Vinaya, Dr. Priya Parvati, Amina Jose and Dr. Sunsu Kurian of the Department of Physics. I commend their steadfast efforts and determination in their research and subjects of choice. Apart from these achievements, our faculty members attended international, national, state and regional level seminars, conferences and workshops and presented papers and served as resource persons. They have also attended orientation programs to keep abreast of the latest developments in their respective fields. Faculty members were also involved in collaborative research projects funded by various agencies and have undertaken many minor and major projects. This year, our students brought laurels to the institution and proved their competency by taking up extracurricular challenges. Amongst many of the laurels, I would like to particularly mention the 84 students of the Department of Sociology for their timely completion of several MOOC courses from international universities. Moving on, I would like to take this opportunity to present and comment a few individual achievements of the students. The following are a few mentions of our students' remarkable feats. Kirti Yadav of the Department of Economics won the Special Jury Award at the National Youth Parliament Festival 2021. Anjali Menon of the Department of Economics won the Certificate of Excellence for successfully completing the Unschool Community Program. Priya Soli of the Department of Economics received a Certificate of Appreciation for being the Campus Ambassador Intern for International Model United Nations. Vani Prashant of the Department of Economics was a delegate to the International Model Union Nations. Ranjana Mary Rajesh of the Department of Mathematics secured the first rank for the PG entrance conducted by the Pondicherry University, Central University of Kerala and the University of Kerala. Lakshmi KV, Shruti Varma and Jinita Teresa were selected for the Summer Fellowship in reputed national institutes. Adira Manohar of the Department of Bharatnatyam received the Popular Award in Classical Dance instituted by the All Kerala Colleges Alumni Forum, UAE. Julia Shaji and Shifa Fatima KS of the Department of History secured the first position in the national level Freedom Quest 2021 organized by MES College, Marampally. Lakshmi Mahesh of the Department of Economics was awarded a Certificate of Appreciation from the TEDx Golden Bridge. T. Anjana Suresh of the Department of Economics received Best Delegate Award in the Young Economics Summit 2021 by MOP Vaishnav College for Women, Chennai. Sanjos A. Thomas, Research Scholar of the Department of Sociology, won the Young Achievers Award 2020 for Modern Trends in Science and Technology. Olivia Valiath and Aisha Shakil published research papers in peer-reviewed journals. Abhirami AK, Tom C. Thomas, Rizveen Shanawas and Sumita Tampan of the Department of Home Science received the Best Oral Presentation Awards. Angel Maria Aju of the Department of Economics secured the third place in the International Art and Craft Competition Artistry at Piasta 2020 organized for differently abled students by the Inter-University Center for Disability Studies, MG University and MES College, Marampally. Gayatri A bagged the first place in the National Elocution Competition. Rowin Samuel of the Department of Sociology secured the first prize in the Interstate Short Story Writing Competition at Chrysalis 2021. Alicia Mariam Bobby and Lavanya Girish of the Department of Physics co-authored the book Fantasy Chase. Apart from these, our students presented papers in various national and international seminars and also published papers in national and international journals. I congratulate all of them for their efforts. As always, the Department of Physical Education brought many laurels to the college and secured the 18th rank among the 225 colleges under the MG University for overall achievements in sports for the year 2020. This year, the department was selected to organize the MG University Badminton Championship. I congratulate the college badminton team for securing the first position in this intercollegiate championship. I congratulate Varsha Venugopal of the Department of English for securing the silver medal in OGSKI International Ekta Championship and Adina JB of the Department of Economics for securing the first position in the Junior State Volleyball Championship. The college badminton team bagged the first position in MG University. The college volleyball team won the first position in the Ernakulam District Senior Volleyball Championship. Kudos to the team. The year and its limitations did not discourage our 193 NSS student volunteers. Thanks to their enthusiasm and the efficient guidance of the program officers, several programs were organized using social media platforms to create awareness on the prevention of COVID, the importance of mental health during the pandemic, and also stressed on the importance of vaccination. The NSS unit initiated the e-library project named Athena and conducted webinars, competitions, tutorials and surveys to spread awareness on issues related to the pandemic. They also organized activities to support environment conservation like Clean Kochi Drive and Sapling Challenge, to name a few. The NCC unit saw an enrollment of 90 student cadets this academic year and remarkably, as always, has witnessed noteworthy achievements in several events, especially in camps ranging from regional to the national level. It is with pride that I mention Ms. Naina Mariam Baby of the Department of Computer Applications, who represented the college at the Republic Day Parade 2021. Further, I am extremely happy to announce that it is for the first time that a senior wing of NCC Navy with a sanctioned strength of 100 cadets was allotted to St. Joseph's College. The naval wing of the college was organized under the 7K Naval Unit NCC. I must congratulate the Deans of the Year 2020-21, Dr. Alfonsa Vijaya Joseph and Dr. Usha Nair, for their relentless and untiring effort, which has helped in the smooth functioning and efficient completion of all college activities. Further, the installation ceremony of the college union was held on 19 January. Ms. Niranjana Anoop from the Department of English was inducted as a chairperson of the college union. Famed actor Padma Shri Dr. Kamal Haasan officially inaugurated the activities of the college union for this academic year. St. Joseph's has always marked and reiterated its identity through the cultural heritage it holds. This year too, the college witnessed a wide array of celebrations and completion of annual activities. The Arts Club inauguration of the year was held on 22nd March in the Platinum Jubilee Auditorium, inaugurated by Padma Bhushan Dr. Mohanlal, followed by the inauguration of Music Club by Padma Bhushan Srimadi K.S. Chitra through virtual platform. The variety of cultural performances that followed added color to the event. This year, Onam was celebrated virtually on 6th September. Titled E-Onam, the event was surely a celebration of colors and culture. Thanks to the cultural events organized by the Students' Union. Actor Indrajit Sugumaran was the chief guest of the event. Christmas too was celebrated virtually and was organized on 1st January 2021 as Extra 2020 Season of Ecstasy. Dr. Divya S. Iyer, IAS, was the chief guest of the event. The various competitions and events which were conducted as part of the celebrations sure brought in the revelries of the season. Adding vigor and dynamism to the campus activities, two interactive sessions were held with eminent leaders Dr. Shashi Tharoor and Sri Rahul Gandhi MP on 15th February and 22nd March respectively. The intent of such sessions was to inspire the students to aspire for good leadership and organizational skills while staying close to one's roots. To bring cheer in the times we are in, the college commemorated special days. The celebrations worked well to impart the spirit of youthfulness, patriotism, and to build strong cultural beliefs and sharing amongst students. Despite hindrances and and the pandemic setbacks, a total of 289 programs were conducted by the college this year. 52 international, 67 national, 54 state and 116 regional webinars, conferences and workshops were organized, each covering a wide range of topics such as dance, media, entrepreneurship, marketing, nanotechnology, career guidance, nutrition, sustainable fashion, economy, environment, conservation and protection, stereographic projection and politics. In addition to all these, intercollegiate competitions were also organized by the Department of Physics and French this year. The college has harbored numerous associations, clubs and cells that conduct academic programs intended to develop awareness, interaction and a sense of responsibility among the students. This year saw additions and the introduction of new initiatives. To mention a few, the Red Cell was timely formed by the Department of Commerce as an initiative to promote entrepreneurial skill and rural commitment among students. Four new incubation units have been initiated under the incubation cell. The Department of Management Studies proudly launched its new consulting initiative, Business Plan Preparation. The Department of Mathematics initiated INME as an incubation unit of math entrepreneurs. Fashion Clinic by the Department of Fashion Designing and Nurture Choco Dreams by the Department of Food Processing Technology. The Science Club was initiated under the guidance of the Department of Computer Applications. The Department of Chemistry inaugurated the Sister Bertel Memorial Knowledge Center for learning and training for various programs like JAM, CSIRNET and Soft Skill Development. The Theresian Film Club was inaugurated by Sri Rasul Pukuti, Oscar-winning sound designer and editor. The club was an initiative by the Department of Communicative English. The Theresian Outreach Program, initiated by the college, is designed to meet the individual needs of selected communities. The outreach program focuses on key areas such as academic improvement, skill development, nutritional awareness, healthcare, and environmental consciousness. The Unnat Bharat Abhiyan, UBA, visions transformation in rural development and is missioned to enable higher education institutions to work with the people of rural India in evolving appropriate solutions for accelerating sustainable growth. It also aims to create a virtuous cycle between society and an inclusive academic system by providing knowledge on the developing needs of rural India. Several activities are organized by different departments of the college in the five UBA panchayats, namely Kunnugara, Mulavagad, Nyarakil, Cheranallur and Kulpilli, to ensure local integration and development. Integrated working with the panchayats and the government bodies, namely Sujitwa Mission, Harita Kerala Mission, Krishi Bhavan and Biodiversity Boards, has helped in promoting practices for rural upliftment. Tutorials and webinars on banking, eco-friendly practices, nutrition and healthcare, and online education were organized this year as part of the UBA mission. Similar measures were practiced to fight against the pandemic. Around 2,500 eco-friendly masks were designed and distributed in the UBA panchayats, ERT office, government treasury, police departments and others to ensure proper safety measures amidst the pandemic. Every department plans and executes extension activities related to their expertise and interest at organizations or institutions in UBA panchayats allotted to the departments. Society of Theresians for Environment Protection, STEP, is formed with the objective of carrying out activities for the protection of environment, usage of biodegradable products, to promote social entrepreneurship among students, provide livelihood to Kudumbashree members and other such ends. With the outbreak of the pandemic, STEP got linked to the virtual world this year and utilized digital marketing through social media platforms to promote their products and services. In addition to the eco-friendly products designed by the team, this year STEP undertook the mission of creating safe, soft toys from shredded waste materials to generate eco-friendly toys for kindergarten kids. It's my privilege to thank the PTA members and the entire parent community of the institution who lent their wholehearted support in all the endeavors and initiatives of the college. The PTA executive members took an active role in collecting parents' feedback on online classes and rendered their support and cooperation for the smooth conduct of the academic programs of the year 2020-21. I also offer my heartfelt gratitude to the PTA members for extending their financial support towards Project Sumanas and e-learning support venture. The Association of St. Rosa's College alumni has been dynamically involved in the overall welfare of the college even during the pandemic. ASTA, along with the UBA project of the college, set up the first line treatment centers in 5 panchayats in the district and allocated Rs 10,000 for each panchayat. They have disbursed a medical aid amounting Rs 81,000 for the spine surgery of an auto driver and for the medical requirements at Shanti Bhavan Palliative Hospital. They have contributed Rs 30,000 for educational purposes and have also contributed a total amount of 65,750 rupees for distributing food to the needy. I congratulate ASTA for their efforts to supply food kits worth Rs 1 lakh to deserving households in the Kunnugara Panchayat. May Lord Almighty strengthen the team to continue being of comfort to all those affected in these despondent times. The college remembers late Reverend Sri Mary Rose of the Department of English, Dr. G. Shantakumari, Department of Hindi, Professor Annie George N. and Professor Annie Noble of the Department of Economics, Professor Annie Chaco, Department of History, Professor Thresiamma Sebastian, Department of Chemistry, Mr. V.S. Vijayan, Department of Bharatanatyam, and Sri Anthony C.J., former gardener of the Department of Botany. Let us remember their dedicated service towards the welfare of the college and pray for the eternal repose of their souls. As I conclude this report, I bow in gratitude before the Lord Almighty, who strengthened each one of us and provided sufficient resources to make all these accomplishments possible. I take this opportunity to commend all the sections of the college community for their unwavering commitment and dedication. Once again, I express my appreciation for the management and faculty for keeping up with the pressures of such a paradigm change. I wish to thank all those who have stood by the institution and all those who have believed in our vision of progress and perfection. May we find peace, meaning, and safety in these trying times. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Reverend Father Ebijan Arakil, the Chancellor of the Archdiocese of Verapalli, is a popular canonist and teacher of Latin in seminaries. He is also a writer and composer and has to his credit several hymns and audio cassettes. It is a great privilege for us to be graced with his presence today. May I now invite him to speak a few words.
Very Reverend Sister Dr. Vinita CSST, the Provincial and Manager and the president of the function, Reverend Sister Emeline, the director, respected principal Dr. Lizzie Matthew, respected Dr. Sajimol Augustine, the senior administrator, Sri P. Chandrasekharan, the PTA vice president, Srimati Suma Ravindran, the president, ASTA, dear staff, my dear parents, and dear students. I am indeed privileged and happy to be a part of the College Day celebrations of St. Teresa's College, the prestigious educational edifice of academic excellence. My greetings to everyone. At the outset, I wholeheartedly congratulate all of you for your commitment and strenuous efforts for various achievements that you have received all these years. I also take this opportunity to congratulate Reverend Sister Vinita for achieving the KCBC Guru Shrestha Award. I would affirm that the secret behind the success of all the Theresians is also due to the powerful mediation of Servant of God, Mother Teresa of St. Rose of Lima, the foundress of CSST congregation, whose fame of sanctity is progressing. It's certainly Mother's holy patronage and prayerful presence that vitalize all the brains and veins who contribute to the very life of this institute. Presently, we are lost in a pandemic. We are unable to meet each other in the campus. Certainly, we feel very sad. But God has opened for us new arenas for meeting each other and for our classes. We are able to excel ourselves in technological expertise. I am sure that soon we will be able to experience the freshness of the Theresian campus. This pandemic will become a memory, and we will surely go back to our colorful life in the nearest future. The academic achievements of St. Teresa's College, the highly valued national, state, and other awards received, the various activities of social commitment, the unique steps taken to dignify human life and render the possible assistance to the community and so on, make us all proud to say that you are great. Congratulations. I prayerfully wish once again every success to all your endeavors, be they academic, extracurricular, spiritual, and social. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Father. Reverend Sister Emlyn has always been an integral part of our institution. She served 19 years as a teacher in the Department of Mathematics and was then appointed principal of the college for 12 years. It was during her tenure that the college garnered various awards for the best principal and best institution. In June 2021, she took over as the director of the institution. It is with great pleasure that I welcome our newly appointed director, Reverend Sister Emlyn, to speak on this occasion.
Dear Dr. Sister Vinita, our provincial superior and manager, our chief guest, Reverend Father Ebijan Arakel, Chancellor, Archdiocese of Verapoli, Dr. Lissy Matthew, our principal, Dr. Sajumal Augustine, our senior administrator, dear parents, friends, well-wishers, members of the staff, both teaching and non-teaching, members of PTA and ASTA, and my dear students, I welcome all of you to the College Annual Day of 2020-2021. St. Teresa's College started her long journey in the field of education in the year 1925. And within 4 years, we'll be celebrating the centenary of the college. The College Day has always been a day of togetherness and display of the Theresian spirit. However, in the present pandemic situation, we have all had to adapt to unprecedented circumstances. All human beings thrive on social contact and interaction. But the COVID virus has erected barriers and separated us from each other. Technology has come to our rescue, and though it is not a substitute, it enables us to keep in touch with each other. All meetings and functions are now being conducted in the virtual world. The College Day is also being conducted online this year. Students need acknowledgement and appreciation of their academic and extracurricular skills. The College Day prizes will motivate them to perform better. The function will also create a sense of unity and oneness with the college. Humans are resilient, and we will surely emerge victorious in our battle with this virus. Altruism and philanthropy are the need of the hour. Let us help and support each other and bring back the world of share and care, smiles and hugs. A word to our outgoing students of UG and PG. Now you are entering a new stage in your life. So my message to you is one of hope. The world, your world, lies before you in it with its problems and opportunities, its aspirations and frustrations. But you have two great assets on your side: your youth with its adaptability and readiness to change, and your Theresian foundation, a foundation laid through the many hours of religion and moral science classes, seminars, retreats, and opportunities you had to plan your activities, competitions, studies, and fun. You now go out as a Theresian. I hope and pray that you remain always true to its ideals and be what the goal of the institution expects: truly liberated women, spiritually enlightened and socially committed. As you go out to join the vast family of Theresians, I keep you in my heart and in my prayers. I wish you success in all that you undertake in the future. May God keep you always in His love. May God Almighty bless all of us. Thank you.
Thank you, sister. I now hand over to Shine Nasser to announce the prizes for the academic year 2020-21.
Good morning. Dedication, hard work, and perseverance ultimately spell. It is now time to honor the achievements of fellow Theresians for this academic year 2020-2021. The special prizes for this year are the Grand Chevalier L.M. Pailey Prize, endowed by Right Reverend Dr. Joseph Kuritara, to be awarded to the student who secures the highest marks for the postgraduate examination, Shruti J., MSc Mathematics. The M.S. Narayan Memorial Prize, instituted by his wife, Gomati Narayanan, awarded to the student who secures the highest marks for BSc degree examinations, Seren Teresa Russell, BSc Physics. She has also been awarded the Sister Emmeline Prize, instituted by Mrs. Thangam Joseph, wife of Dr. C.M. Joseph, to be awarded to the student who secures the highest marks for BSc degree examination. The special prize awarded by the college in memory of late Ms. Saroja G. to the student who secures the highest marks in the SSLC examination from among the children of the non-teaching staff. Nevin Anthony, son of Ms. Minnie Vijay, Department of Botany, and Maria Joshna John, daughter of Gigi John, Department of Chemistry. The Mother Rita Memorial Prize awarded to the student who secures the highest number of points at the MG University Youth Festival, Amrita Varsha K, BCom Taxation Self-Financing. The Centenarian N.C. Krishnan Nambiar Memorial Prize, instituted by his daughter, Professor Vilasini Devi VP, to be awarded to an outstanding student of the college, Dina Susan Jacob, 3rd BA Economics. The Professor Samuel Matai Prize, instituted by the staff of St. Teresa's College, to be given to a student of the BA or BSc class for exemplary service and excellence in co-curricular activities from NCC, CQMS Lakshmi V, 3rd BSc Mathematics, and from the NSS, Maria Elsa, 2nd BA English Language and Literature. The Mother Mary Prize, instituted by the late Mrs. Rose George Paiyappally, to be awarded to an outstanding student of first degree class, Anakha Rajiv, 1st BSc Botany. Mr. J.E. Kurian Memorial Prize, awarded by his wife, Betty Kurian, to the best class representative of the year, Teja Sunil, 1st BSc Zoology. Professor Betty Kurian Prize, awarded to a student for her outstanding performance in theatrical events, Anna Susan Roy, 3rd BSc Zoology. The Sini Jacob Kuripad Memorial Scholarship, instituted by her parents to be given to a student for her meritorious service in extension activities, Shweta K.R., 3rd BSc Physics. The Odathu Parambil Francis Xavier Memorial Scholarship, awarded by his wife, Srimati Mary Agnes, to a student for outstanding performance in literary events, Kirti Yadav, 1st BA Economics. The University Women's Association of Cochin Prize, awarded to the best debater, Niranjana R, 3rd BA English Language and Literature. The Maria Philip Memorial Merit Cum Mean Scholarship, instituted by Maria Philip Educational Trust, to be awarded to a student for all-round performance, Maxlin M. Maxey, 2nd BA English Language and Literature. The Mother Veronica Prize, awarded to a student who makes best use of the library, Kengjum Thapo, 2nd BSc Home Science. The Sister Benhilda Prize, instituted by the non-teaching staff, awarded to an outstanding member of the Jesus Youth, Rachel Filton, 3rd BSc Physics. The Alapad Sisters Prize, awarded to a deserving differently able student, goes to Anjali Bino, 3rd BA English Language and Literature. The Reverend Sister Dr. Teresa, former principal, St. Teresa's College Endowment Prize, instituted by PTA, to be awarded to the best union member for the year 2020-21, Varsha Venugopal, 2nd BA English Language and Literature. The Reverend Sister Dr. Vinita, former principal, St. Teresa's College Prize, to be awarded to the union member for her selfless service, Aisha Almas PA, 2nd BSc Zoology. The Reverend Sister Christabel, former principal, St. Teresa's College Endowment Prize, instituted by PTA, to be awarded to the best Red Cross volunteer for the year 2020-21. Sandra Benny, 3rd DC BWOC Food Processing Technology, and Atulya Sunil, 3rd BSc Mathematics. The Sister Emmeline Prize, instituted by the students of St. Teresa's College 1997-98, to be awarded to a student who combines academic merit with extracurricular excellence, Salma Sahir, 3rd BA English Language and Literature. Special Prize for National Level Representation from NCC, Senior Wing Army, Senior Under Officer, Bhavna S. Pai, 3rd BA Communicative English. She attended the Republic Day Parade at New Delhi and won the gold medal for All India Best Cadet, the special prize for national level representation from NCC. Junior Under Officer M. Naina Mariam Baby, 3rd BSc Computer Science. She attended the Republic Day Parade at New Delhi and was selected for the Rajpath March. Now we move on to special prizes awarded for outstanding achievements in sports at international, national and intercollegiate level for the academic year 2020-2021. Varsha Venugopal of 2nd DC English Literature secured silver medal in OGSKI International E-Kata Championship and participated in National Karate Dojo Association Online Championship. Reza Farhat of 3rd BCom won the first position in the MG University Intercollegiate Badminton Championship and was selected to represent MG in the All India Inter-University Championship. Anakendu V of 2nd DC English Literature participated in the South Zone National Shooting Championship held at Chennai. Anjali Pradeep of 2nd BA Communicative English won the first position in the MG University Intercollegiate Badminton Championship and was selected to represent MG University in the All India Inter-University Championship. Mary Tanya of 2nd DC Chemistry participated in the Senior National Wushu Championship held at Chandigarh from 25th February to 2nd March 2021. Anne George of 1st BMS won the first position in the MG University Intercollegiate Badminton Championship and was selected to represent MG University in the All India Inter-University Championship.
Let me now invite Srimati Suma Ravindran, President of ASTHA, to speak a few words on this occasion.
Respected teachers, students, parents, ASTHAites and well-wishers. Congratulations on another year of achievements and laurels despite the constraints of COVID. When I was asked to record a message from ASTHA, I spent a lot of thought on what it should be. And I got my topic, mental health. After I zeroed in on the topic, I discussed it with the other committee members and I'm adding all their suggestions to this. Nothing is normal about the times we are passing through. And you children and the senior, very senior citizens are the true victims of it. It's true that your academic education is progressing well, as well as circumstances will allow. And being a member of this institution means that your academic future is well cared for. But school and college is much more than that. They are the first line arena that teach you about life, about people, about the highs and lows of interpersonal relationships. They give you experiences that teach you how far you can go to test the rules and regulations of the institution and of society. You learn how to deal with different kinds of people among the staff and students. You get opportunities to play the fool and be a fool. You get laughed at, praised, admonished, punished, forgiven, all within the same space. You learn from different people and situations and decide on what you want and what not to be. Nothing can replace this real-life education within the secure environs of a community that will look after you. Corona has made this much-needed exposure alien to you, but that means you have to gain the same experience within the restrictions. How? Books. Read as much of fiction as you can. Read as many magazines as you can get your hands on to. Read the newspapers regularly. Try not to depend on the digital media for news. They are all biased and corrupt. Then, books have been my best ally throughout life. There are other ways in which you can keep your mind engaged. I see that multitasking, doing many tasks at the same time, is what is keeping me sane in this situation. You can take up new hobbies. The options are many on the virtual platform. Members of ASTHA committee are learning music, dance, painting, embroidery, stitching, gardening, and a lot more. We are connecting with each other regularly, especially when we sense that one or the other of us needs to talk. Most importantly, connect firmly with your family. Find games and activities that you can enjoy together. Take turns to take over domestic duties. Take time to enjoy nature, the photos and TV programs. I enumerated these just to tell you to keep yourself busy and not on the digital media. Talk to others about your worries, cares and concerns. Listen to others when they speak to you. Express yourself in whichever way you can, but most importantly, stay interactive and connected. The only way out of this is to stay mentally healthy. Take adequate care and precaution, but don't let life pass you by. I wish you all a very bright future and the college and an ever more productive year ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I now welcome Sri Chandrasekharan, Vice President of the PTA, to offer his felicitations.
Bahumanapetta Varapalli Adirupada Chancellor, Reverend Father Ebigin Arakel. Bahumanapetta Reverend Dr. Sister Vinita, Provincial Superior and Manager, St. Teresa's. Reverend Sister Emily, Director, St. Teresa's College. Dr. Lizzie Matthew, Principal, St. Teresa's College. Dr. Sajimola Augustine, Senior Administrator and Former Principal, St. Teresa's College. Mrs. Suma Asta, President, Priyamula Vidyarthini Suhurthukale. St. Teresa's College in the College Day, 96th College Day, your platform in Nagunda. COVID and the Mahamari, Logatagaman and Vidyarthi Sajedil. Campus Sagari, Varnabushpangal Vidari, Santosha Tindayim, Akhada Tindayim, Padayim, Naranjan Likandai and Dirishatil. Iteratil Bedwadi, Naratu Yalade, Namadamumbil, Matumadangilla. Nal. കാലം ഇവിടെ അവസാനിക്കുകയല്ല. പ്രത്യാശയുടെയും പ്രതീക്ഷയുടെയും വർണ്ണകിരണങ്ങൾ പെയ്തിറങ്ങിക്കൊണ്ട് നാളേക്ക് മുന്നോട്ട് ചിന്തിക്കുകയും അതിനനുസരിച്ച് പ്രവർത്തിക്കുകയുമാണ് നമ്മൾ ചെയ്യേണ്ടത്. തീർച്ചയായിട്ടും കോവിഡിൻ്റെ കാർമേഘം മാറി വരും. ജീവിതത്തിൽ പ്രത്യാശയോടെ നനുത്ത ദിനങ്ങൾ വർണ്ണശോഭയോടുകൂടി പെയ്തിറങ്ങും. അതിനുവേണ്ടി നമുക്കൊരുമിച്ച് പ്രയത്നിക്കാം, ഒരുമിച്ച് മുന്നോട്ട് പോകാം. ഈ സന്തോഷകരമായിട്ടുള്ള ദിവസത്തിന്, ഈ കോളേജ് ഡേയുടെ സമയത്തിന്, ഇതിൽ വിജയികൾക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കും കോളേജ് പി ടി എയുടെ പേരിൽ ഊഷ്മളമായ ആശംസകൾ അർപ്പിക്കുന്നു. നന്ദി, നമസ്കാരം.
താങ്ക് യു സർ. As we come to the close of today's function, we would like to place on record our gratitude to all the people who made this possible. On behalf of the management, staff and students, a special word of thanks to our chief guest for accepting our invitation and the significant message he delivered to us today since. Our Provincial Superior, Reverend Dr. Sister Vinita, Director, Reverend Sister Emlyn, Senior Administrator, Dr. Sajimola Augustine, and Principal, Dr. Lizzie Matthew, compliment one another with their distinct strengths and talents, and we are honored to have them with us. Acknowledgements are also due to Srimati Suma Ravindran and Sri Chandrasekharan, representatives of the alumna and PTA, for their unstinted loyalty and support. And finally, a warm thanks to all the members of the Theresian family who joined us online in this celebration, without whom no function would be complete. Thank you all once again.